Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, depending where you are. I would like to greet the President of the United Nations Commission on International Trade Law, 54th session, the Vice President of the Commission, the distinguished delegates from all the different countries, all present international organizations, the UNCITRAL Secretariat, all colleagues and respected audience and participants. As acting Colombian Superintendent of Companies, it is a privilege to have been invited to share with you the legislative emergency changes made by Colombia in the insolvency statute as a result of the world pandemic generated by the COVID-19. No one would have ever anticipated a global situation with such devastating, unbearable, and long-lasting effects in the overall well-being of the population and businesses worldwide. And never had I considered having to face such unexpected situation as the head of the Superintendency of Companies, an institution which not only has administrative competences to oversee compliance of corporate laws, but also manage all businesses' insolvencies as a judge. In fact, using historic financial information of 15,000 companies, the superintendency identified companies' risks of insolvency with two scenarios in which the GDP were to decrease. The result showed that between 18 to 37% of the companies in the sample had risks of insolvencies and a catastrophe, considering Colombia had 1.6 million registered businesses and a large informal economy. The study also concluded that micro and small businesses would have been most likely to have risks of insolvency than medium and large businesses. Thus, when the pandemic started, the superintendency presented to the government two proposals to include tools in the insolvency regime to deal with the emergency. These proposals were developed taking as basis the superintendency's roundtables in 2019 as part of the commemoration of its 18th anniversary, where we worked with business and insolvency law experts and considered the recommendation of the draft paper for micro and small enterprises of UNCITRAL. These proposals became Decrees 560 and 7072 of 2020 due to the special powers granted to the government to deal with the emergency. Decree 560 created two procedures with minimum intervention of the insolvency judge, an emergency negotiation of reorganization agreement, we call it NEAR, to be held directly between debtors and creditors, and an enterprise reorganization agreements procedure, we call it PRES, to be held in the Chamber of Commerce with the intervention of a mediator. Both procedures require a judicial validation and have a time frame of 3 months to negotiate and present an agreement for validation. Decree 7072 creates an abbreviated reorganization and a simplified judicial liquidation processes for micro and small enterprises with reduced procedural formalities and timeframes. The decrees for all processes and procedures only require for admission a check control of documentary completion and include financial tools to finance and alleviate debtors, deep finance and other tools, the use of technology and artificial intelligence, and flexibilization of assets conversion and disposal as a public auction, among other facilities. This decree supplements the general statute of insolvency and general principles of insolvency law apply in these processes and procedures as well. The following are some of the most important and basic principles that Colombia incorporated in these decrees, which consider the recommendations of the draft text for micro and small enterprises, not without mention that Colombia's general statute of insolvency already contains many of the recommendations of the UNCITRAL legislative guide on insolvency law. First, key objectives of a simplified insolvency legislation. Colombia enacted a simplified insolvency regime in Decree 7072 that includes an expeditious, simple, and flexible procedure for micro and small enterprises, easy access with the use of electronic standard formats, and flexible check of basic documentary completion and tools to preserve investment and employment where a reorganization is possible. Second, scope of a simplified insolvency regime, application to all MSEs. According to Decree 7072, simplified regime is available to all commercial businesses, legal and natural persons. This includes not only companies, but also non-merchants, which are controllers of companies. To qualify, debtor must have assets of less than $1.2 million. Third, types of simplified insolvency proceedings. Decree 7072 allows to have both a reorganization and a liquidation simplified processes. Four, institutional framework. Recommendations state the need to define and specify the competent authority and its functions. Moreover, it is suggested to have specialized judges on insolvency matters that rule on the admission, opening, dismissing, and closing the process, that recognize or reject credits presented by creditors, notify decisions, oversee the entire process, and verify the approval of agreements by creditors, among other duties. In accordance, Decree 7072 appointed the Superintendency of Companies as the judge of micro and small businesses insolvencies with all those powers, as they are included in the insolvency law statute. Five, support for the use of a simplified insolvency regime. Recommendations also suggest the adoption of measures that facilitate access to process and the use, among others, of standardized forms and templates with mechanisms for automatic verification of errors for the presentation of online applications. This would, at a minimum, allow the information provided by the applicant to be stored electronically in a database. In order to undertake a holistic approach to ease the burden of an application and address all needs, as permitted by Decree 7072, the Superintendency created the insolvency module in its web page. Applications for admissions for all simplified proceedings are to be presented and processed through a portal, which is a web tool with artificial intelligence so that users can fill out easily standardized templates and formats and submit their application for admission virtually, therefore reducing paperwork and associated costs for debtors. Other benefits of using the insolvency module are biometric authentication of users, and automatic error checking and visual aids, tooltips, which help the presentation of the admission and guarantee immediate organization of data. 6, main features of the simplified insolvency regime. In a nutshell, given the limit or the time limit, the abbreviated reorganization process is more agile, with shorter terms and with fewer procedural stages. So it is fully set forth in only 2 hearings, being the first a conciliation meeting, hearings that facilitate claims, resolutions, and guarantee the participation of all creditors directly in the hearings. The simplified liquidation process is more agile, with shorter terms and with fewer procedural stages, and include new tools for assets conversion and creditors payment. Debtor must prepare financial information based on the net settlement value as mandated by international financial reporting standards, which avoids the need to make new appraisals. Now, I would like to present some of the key numbers regarding insolvency proceedings in Colombia, administered by the Superintendency of Companies. A total of 1,628 filings to initiate insolvency processes and procedures have been presented from April 1st, 2020 to June 24th, 2021. 78% for reorganization, and 22% for liquidation. 18% of the filings are for the judicialized procedures of Decree 560. 56% of the filings are for processes of Decree 7072 for micro and small businesses with assets of less than $1.2 million. 26% of the filings are for regular insolvency processes. Admissions of the proceedings due to technological and administrative changes in the superintendency are taking less time than before. Admissions used to take between 8 to 12 months in 2019. Nowadays, admissions take between 2 weeks and 1.5 months. Regarding the duration of the simplified insolvency processes, the abbreviated reorganization process takes an average of 5.5 months, and the simplified liquidation process, 6 months. This is a substantial reduction, as the regular reorganization process takes an average of 20 months, and a regular liquidation process, an average of 22 months. To conclude, I would like to highlight that due to the economic crisis generated by the pandemic and its major effects on micro and small businesses and their special needs, and the evident good experience Colombia has had with a simplified regime for micro and small enterprises, it is highly recommended that the UNCITRAL, Group 5th, and the Commission finish, approve, and make available to all countries these recommendations, as they will be very helpful to make legislative changes that would allow countries to cope with this crisis. Thank you very much for the opportunity and your time.